Good evening, everyone. I am Azrael Johnson. You are wholesomely welcomed to our classy, elegant, and also savage night of poetry. Ironclad, here at the Icon Images Gallery, please clap for our hosts. We have three amazing performers tonight, two poets and a musician. I'm sure you will love all of them, because I love all of them. And you all love me. That's fine. Couple of announcements. We have some books back there. We have some t-shirts back there. If you buy anything at all today, or if you just want one, I have copies of my artisan crafted CD, As Real, if you want copies of that. I'll just bring to you. I'll sign them if you want them. But I mean, I would rather you buy things. Because all the money we collect goes towards the poets that we are having perform tonight. So, poets and musicians. All right, without further ado, let me introduce our first performer. She is a poetress of her own kind. Please welcome Nick Anger.
Us in people, but it sure as hell do the same. This generation, my generation, their generation is not broken. Yours just simply does not understand. Think of this moment the next time you want to say, when I was a kid, when I was a kid, when I was a kid. We are kids. And they say, I say, we are not broken.
Kid.
They give a single second of reassurance and fixing it. Then that moment is gone, and you realize the pain is still there. The scars stay. I wear bracelets now over my scars, not because I am ashamed of who I am, but simply because others don't understand. It is mentally a pain unexplainable. There is nothing more difficult than to feel like you have to. There's nothing more difficult than to feel like you have to battle your body to defend yourself from the monsters in your head that beat the feelings of depression, anger, and sadness into your mind to the point you feel you must destroy yourself. You feel your beauty is valueless and monsters control every inch of your being inside and out. There is no crying without blades. There is no sadness without blades. There is no life without blades looking next to you. There will always be temptations. I still hear the echoes of the metal clashing and voices, but now they are just hushed tones. I'm not saying I will hear them screaming sometimes, because I do. But now it is more like they're screaming with duct tape over their mouths, and I hear more of a muffled, hard-to-make-out sounds rather than painful, murderous screams. There are more whispered temptations of memory slowly fading away with every breath. Every breath gets a little easier to breathe, like weights have been lifted little by little each day. Each time one lifts itself, I stand taller than the day I did before. I'm 9 months clean today. 10. I'm running toward you tomorrow. Trust me, I refuse to let them defeat me. I will rise the rest of my life clean. I will be pure from September 29th, 2014 until the day that I die. I refuse to die with any more self-inflicted scars on me than this moment in time. I will never again give in to the monster screaming, "Nagan, Nagan, Nagan, use us, use us, shut up." I refuse, I scream back. I mean it this time. I'm really done this time. I am 9 minutes clean today. Soon it will be 10, 11, a year, 2, 3, a decade, the rest of my life, I will always stay clean. I will always be clean. I promise you that they will not win this fight. They will not take me hostage again. I will rise a champion. I am a warrior, and I will fight until the day I die to my blades. That is a personal promise from me to you. Photos selected. Cancel or okay? Push okay. Delete it. 1, 117, 2, 117, 3, 117, 4, 117. I could still press cancel. I could still do it. I could hit cancel, call him, and forgive him just like all the other times. I could do it. I'm thinking about doing it. But the more I think I want to, the more I begin to cry, the more I think that all the bad times we had together. One good picture hides 100 nights spent alone, 1,000 lies, and 1,000,000 arguments. I can look at a photo and remember at the end of the day we were already on round 3 of an argument. I can look at a picture and remember brokenness from that day. 15 of 117, 16 of 117, 17 of 117, 18 of 117. I sit here and stare at the photo from the day I first met you. I think to myself, how could all that lead to this? You say I made you the way you are? Uncaring, selfish, angry, sad, the list goes on. You say from one mistake 3 months ago that I deserve to be miserable forever. That makes everything you have ever done to me okay. 27 of 117, 28 of 117, 29 of 117, 30 of 117, 31 of 117. At this point, I still stare at the cancel button, waiting for myself to push it because every single other time I always have, they tell me that you have me wrapped around your finger. I say no because I am a strong woman who doesn't take orders from anyone. Why do they say that to me? But when I sit there knowing I will press cancel, I think harder. I really figure I would press cancel because I have every other time we break up, get back together over and over again. I have lost track of how many times by now. The fact that I figure I would press cancel proves I am wrapped around your finger. I get it now. But this time I don't cry sad tears. I begin to cry angry ones. angry for how much time I spent hoping you would change. Angry for how much I hurt myself waiting for it to happen. Angry for every time you treated me bad in front of people and I was embarrassed yet said nothing. Angry for every time I foolishly forgave you, even after the millions of broken promises you handed me. Angry for just finally accepting my assignments you made me feel forced to give you. 52 of 117, 53 of 117, 54 of 117, 55 of 117. You told me you would never end up being bad material for me to write. You promised, you lied. Yet now I sit here broken in too many pieces to keep track of. Maybe they are deleting too. Probably I do feel an emptiness. But again, I feel so foolish for falling in love with you over and over and over again, even after the lies, broken promises, screaming matches, and hate we threw toward each other. 65 of 117, 66 of 117, 67 of 117, 68 of 117, 69 of 117. The number is getting higher. Should I hit cancel? You make plans with her an hour after we hang up the phone. Apparently our relationship was not what I thought it was. If it's over for you already. After everything by now, I am done being sad. I am just so angry for I wasted the past 2 years of my life on someone who doesn't seem to love me as much as I love them. You don't purposely hurt the one you truly love, do you? Maybe I'm confused. Confused on how this is supposed to work. Am I supposed to continue to forgive you for this? Is mental abuse just as bad as physical? 91 of 117, 92 of 117, 93 of 117, 94 of 117. My PTSD bites me mentally every day. I have enough battles to fight in my head without you in the picture. 106 of 117, 107 of 117, 108 of 117. Why must I be the one to care too much? It is just a button. Either push it or not. I get why everyone's overhearing me complain and cry about you because by this point I'm doing it to myself. 111 of 117, 112 of 117, 113 of 117. I'm killing myself by hoping for something that will never happen. I am breaking every day. 114 of 117. I am already broken. 115 of 117. So I guess this is it. All the memories left in my mind. God, don't ever let me forget the good ones or even the worst of them so I know not to do this to myself again. 116 of 117. Just hit cancel, Nikki, my mind whispers. No. 117 photos deleted.
Yes.
Hi, Sophie, can I look up and tell you?
There are seats up here. I can look my shit.
Oh, whatever you
know. There's one up there.
You were doing it. No, I was going to text you for it.
Yeah, I'm sorry, my boss is being late. And it's screwed, you know.
That happens. You want to use my phone?
Start this race all over again with the men I have now. I would send the first message all over again, meet a stranger hoping to one day fall in love all over again. I won't be like them, like the idiots and the assholes. I refuse to be the heartbreaker or to have my heart broken. I'm tired of going on adventures only to stop halfway through the journey. You tell me that we have all the time in the world, all the time in the world, because you want to spend that time with me. You said you want to get to the point where you marry me one day. You said that's the goal for me. heard nothing, but oh, if you could translate my silence, you would have heard speech so deafening it would make us have to sign to each other. My knees shook with fear that for a split second that maybe you regretted it after you said it, because everyone else has before. I'm in no way saying that I'm perfect. I will have days where it seems like the world is ending. All you must do is make me feel like you're protecting me like it actually is. I'll get mad, cry for no reason sometimes, because I just feel so overwhelmed with my life. Some little things are big things to me. Just remind me that we are colossal in this world as long as we are together. Let me know that the demons I fear every day are only in my head, and you will fight this battle with me. I'm in no way saying that I'm perfect, but I can promise you this, no pinky promise, because to me that commitment is sacred. I will fight hard, but I will love hard too. I was raised that way. I'll care more about you than I do myself. You'll come home to random surprises like notes on the door saying welcome home baby, even if you just really went to the store real quick. I can promise you to make you laugh in the most inappropriate times. I will tell you every single day repeatedly how much I will love you forever. Baby, I won't be like them. I know you won't be like them. They say when you meet the one, you'll know. I told you, I don't know what I feel, but I feel what I feel is harder and bolder than anything I've ever felt before. I said, I don't love you right at this moment, but I want to. When I told you those things, I honestly thought I was going to throw up. I did not think I would be able to get the words from my mouth properly, because every time I poured my heart out like an ocean of words, someone drowns me in it. I panicked after I said it, thinking maybe I should have just stayed in my mind's deafening silence. Yet before I could even realize I was panicking in the first place, you said, I feel it too. Neither of us knowing what the hell that actually even means, but I guess you do. You asked me what the word for almost love is, and I told you I don't know. Only for you to say, well, whatever it is, that's how I feel. You don't want to tell me that you love me, because love means a lot when you've been broken too many times. Baby, I will build you into the castle that you deserve to be. I don't know what the word is that I feel. There is not a word for this. You have left this poetress silent. I have never felt this before in my life. That's how I know we will not be like them. Because I am 100% yours. I am your girl, and I won't be like them.
She's not currently watching.
I told her to watch.
Well, she was for a minute. We're going to do three different videos, so she can still get here.
Oh, no, I told her to watch Nick Ann.
Okay.
Well, then oh, thanks! I know I love you. Just
recording this, or are you streaming this?
What's that?
Are you just recording this, or are you streaming this?
We're streaming it, and then it's going to go up on YouTube later.
Oh, okay, cool.
Okay. I don't
have
any
good
problems.
What
do
you mean,
this one's called Weapons. Again, just put this in because I need to fill time. They burnt me down into pieces as small as ashes. Yet I found a way to piece myself back together before they had the chance to clear me away. I wouldn't let them leave me empty as if I was some sort of slave. They tried to fracture my heart and leave, but I did not let their actions get away. I kept them close to me and began to gain myself from their ways. I learned to rebuild myself with the broken bones they left me with. I learned to paste together pieces too small to see. I even had to relearn to breathe. I learned to see through the eyes of blind men. Not the kind of blind where they can't see anything, but the kind where it is more like a shadow around them. I learned not to only see the broken pieces, yet the good ones too. I had to teach myself not everything is the end, but just a page out of the story, and the next chapter could be great. I spent too many days trying to wash down the I hate yous and I love yous, and the why are you even here anymore is with too much of my own blood. I tried swallowing my medication, but my brain always said I'm already swallowing you anyway, so why bother?
Yes.
The battle I face against my own mind is a hard one. But I have taught myself to throw away the bad weapons and take out the good. I learned to put down the blades and pick a pencil and paper instead. You would be amazed at how many demons I have conquered with just a keyboard. So that the monsters and demons inside my head be ready, for I have just picked a pen. I have two more. So this is new. This phone, the only person that's ever heard it is my mom. Aww. So, right, this is called The Dark Place. Standing in the dark place. The dark place. I want it to be light in here, but it's too dark in here, place. I can feel my demons hiding in here, place. Is there enough air in here, place? I don't think there's enough air in here, place. I feel stranded here in the dark place, here in the alone place. I feel like paper quickly skimming through the shredder. I can feel their teeth driving into my skin like arms on my skin on my arms with razor blades here. Wait, that's me. Those are razor blades, but I swear they're the ones making me do it. Please believe me. Doesn't anyone see that I'm drowning by breathing this air? I don't know what it's called when you feel like you're drowning in air. I'm suffocating. I'm suffocating in here. The things my own brain says locks me in a coffin buried 10 miles deep. They won't let me escape here. The dark place itself drags me into the dark place. I go to sleep. It does not stop. My body shakes so horribly. I do not rest. The dark place makes even my dreams become part of the dark place. I awaken, but today feels different. Today I push through the monsters into a new place because I see a part of the light. I see it. I have never seen the light here before. It's always been known as the dark place. I live every day of my life here, place. The dark place. And now I see a light, the smallest shimmer of light, but that is enough for me. Yesterday I had nothing, so today I will take that light and run as fast as I possibly can with it. It is no longer the dark place. Now it is the hope place, because I will fight with the light I see here now. I will make this place the hope place. No, I will make this place the, I will win this fight place. This will now be known as the warrior place, because I yes. am ready to fight. I would lock myself away with her like the princess that she is. You were supposed to be her king, but you are nothing. You are the jester in this fairy tale. The joke here is you. She needs to be taught that she is a castle concealed with gold, only to be opened by those who are worthy. She must know to hold her chin high so her tiara does not fall. I will teach her how to swim instead of drown in her own tears. She will look into the mirror, never doubting if she is the fairest of them all, because I will let her know every single day how beautiful she truly is. This little girl will always know I will be her knight in shining armor when she is afraid. The only fire that will catch the tower she lives in will be from that which burns from her passionate soul. She will know undoubtedly that princesses are able to save themselves too. We don't always need a prince. We don't always need a king either. She learned at a young age that queens are just as capable of being the king also.
Yes.
So you just live as the jester. She will live happily ever after, perfectly fine without you.